Hi, this is Omar Qureshi, और आज मूड है चोर पुलिस खेलने का. I'll be the police because I'm sitting with a चोर, actually crook. Imran Hashmi plays crook in his next movie, which is also called Crook. Hi, Imran.
Welcome. How are you doing?
All good. Have you been a crook in real life?
Well, yeah, done some crooked things. Yeah. Wouldn't want to go into the details in the show. So I think we've all done that in our lives. We've done unethical things according to the terms of society, what they dictate as right and wrong.
So how bad did you get?
Pretty bad, yeah.
But I would think that you would be better at playing house because your kissing expertise is very good.
I can do that on screen. So we leave it out of personal life and play house. I play too much of house on screen already.
But you mastered the art of being bad boy in Bollywood. Like you love doing these roles.
Yeah. I don't know about master the art, but definitely the roles that come my way. Mm-hmm. And I've been very fortunate to get so many great roles in that. Mm-hmm. That kind of, you know, form of characters. And the lines between the good guy and the bad guy somewhere have been blurred. Yeah, yeah. And I think Once Upon a Time in Mumbai has, in a very interesting way, if you see the film, analyze the film, Shoaib's character, the bad guy, the ultra bad guy, survives in the end. 2 years ago, probably the audience would have crucified a guy like that. Yeah. They would want the savior, Sultan's character, to kind of live on, and the bad guy to die. Yeah. But it shows a very interesting trend. If the audience has endorsed a film like this, it's a change in their mindset. They see characters differently. Good guys do bad things sometimes. Bad guys do good things sometimes. So that's where Crook comes in. He's got everything. He's got both those sides of the personality, the angel and the demon inside him. So that's what it is.
The good things you did in the movie were Prachi Desai.
Yeah, I guess the romantic bit was probably the only savior and made the character extremely endearing. But otherwise, pretty bad stuff in the film,
Because she's a good girl. Her image is very good, very clean, squeaky clean, Bahu. And suddenly you're like...
There are 2 minutes of screen time with Imran Hashmi and there goes the Bahu image out of the window.
Yeah. You enjoy that, don't you?
I don't. I felt really bad. I asked Milan again. I was like, you know, I'm going to make her do this because, you know, she's built it up over 2 years and that's kind of a brand that she has. Yeah, but she wanted to also break away and completely surrender herself to what the director's vision was. That's good.
Once Upon a Time in Mumbai, another success for you. You know, feels good, right?
Of course it does. I think for the entire crew, a lot of hard work from their end. We'd seen the film. Right. We'd seen a couple of screenings. We knew we had a superb film at hand. But then when the audience endorses your film, and I went and saw it in single screens. Yeah. I saw it in Getty. I saw it in a couple of other single screens. It's the kind of film you got to watch in a single screen. I think multiplex audience also was reacting in the same way. They were clapping, they were whistling, they were laughing. Yeah. So that's nice. It's great when people are so vocal about, you know, the things that you felt would work in a film.
But grey characters always stick. Like Sultan was very clean. You know, he was a bad guy, but he was a clean bad guy.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, you're a bad guy.
Yeah,
In real life, what would you rather be?
I think I would be probably a blend of both. I think to deal with the world today, you got to be slightly devious.
Yeah.
If you're too good, if you're too nice, if you're squeaky clean, people step all over you. I think you need to be prepared for that. Nice guys finish last. So
in the movie, Sultan got shot.
as long as you don't hurt anyone, I think there has to be part of you that, you know, the no-nonsense part. If someone messes with you, you probably shouldn't take it lying down. I think that's kind of mantra for this generation, at least.